Let's talk about Ben and Jerry's.
They tweeted this out.
It's 4th of July. It's high time we recognize that the U.S. exists on stolen indigenous land and commit to returning it. Leftists love like beautiful infographics that educate you on an issue that they're doing nothing about. But a tribe, the Abenakis, has come forward and actually pointed out that Ben and Jerry's headquarters rests on the stolen land of this tribe that is based in Vermont. And what did they hear?
Crickets. Nothing. It was silent.
And they even got their own little community note on Twitter saying, despite Ben and Jerry's supposed commitment to returning land they feel was stolen, they have yet to reach out to the tribe whose land their headquarters is on and arrange a return of the land to them.
Terrorists have rebranded themselves as superheroes, freedom fighters, and forefathers. In response to wars they create, they brand themselves as the protagonists of any situation. Europeans branded themselves as Americans. And to hide the fact that they rebranded themselves as Americans, on top of the original Americans here, they don't refer to themselves as European Americans, but they refer to you as African Americans.
You know, the $5 people act like we don't have any proof that we are the Aboriginal people to the Americas. But every time we post the proof, they report the videos and try to get them taken down. So it seems like you know we're telling the truth, you just don't want the rest of the world to know we're telling the truth.
They're the saviors of the world. They have the evolved intelligence. They are holier than thou, embodied. The most beautiful, the cleanest, the most intelligent and self-righteous beings of all humanity. They are beyond the beasts of burden they have been entrusted by God to usher into the right and only kind of civilization. They wear this weight on their shoulders. We are their responsibility. The unclean ones. The unintelligent. The savage. These beasts who require guidance. Divine guidance. Just as it was their divine place, they have a divine authority, a destiny to be manifest into this world by God, entrusted by God to civilize these savage beasts.
Often white people will meet a black person who completely challenges every racial stereotype that they've ever had. Rather than giving up the stereotype, they create a special category for that person and say, well, you're not like other black people. Or instead of saying, my ideas of black people were too narrow or too... And I think that's the tragedy of any kind of prejudicial thinking, that when we confront the circumstance that tells us it's not so, we frequently don't enlarge our sense of things. We actually come up with new ways to protect and defend that way of thinking.
This mentality has not been dealt with. This is still the norm. To believe, to feel that way is the norm. They don't have to say it. It's in the books. It's in the institutions. It's in the political scene. This is the culture.
Well, the government wants to be the father. This has all been intentional. Remove the father from the home so we can come in and we can take over. Make sure that the mother is not in the home, that the mother is working, you know, maybe two jobs or whatever, trying to survive, so we can completely indoctrinate that child with whatever it is that we want to indoctrinate them with. So if the father is out of the home, which I think that the original structure of the nuclear family worked best for us. That's my personal opinion. The father is being the provider and the mother has the time to nurture. But when you have the father removed from the home and the mother working 40 to 80 hours a week, then what are we doing? We are sending our children to school every single day, Monday through Friday. And now that teacher has somewhat become the parent, and this school has now taken over the role of parenting. And what are they doing? They are teaching your children. They are indoctrinating your children 8 hours a day, Monday through Friday. And then when our children grow up and they're 16 and 17 and we're sitting across from them and we realize, you don't have the same morals I do. You don't have the same beliefs that I do. You don't have the same educational background that I do. It's because we haven't taught them. We've allowed someone else to teach them. We've allowed someone else to give them their beliefs, their morals, their structure. And we'll be sitting across from our child at 16, 17 years old and not even know who that person is. And I think that it has all been very strategic.
When you look around and you see other people around the world, you can understand their culture. They wear their culture like a badge of honor. Everywhere else in the world, it's an honorable act to share and express your culture. Only in the Western world is culture this ambiguous, taboo even, thing that really doesn't exist. It doesn't exist because the people know what that culture is. And if you define it, it's like putting a name to a ghost. It makes it real. It brings it so much into the forefront of your reality, you can no longer live by the illusions. You can't look the other way. It forces you to directly look right into what is happening. So they demonize all culture and say it's not about culture. Culture doesn't exist anymore the way it used to with the savages. The modern, more evolved form of interacting is beyond culture. If anything, we have a culture of evolution. We have a culture of technology. We have a culture of moving forward. Then they sprinkle in the extra stuff, a culture of wanting to save the planet, protect humanity. But you know that's all bullshit. It's all a ploy to hide the original intention, which is to control and dominate any and everything in this reality.
The crown is not the British royal family. The real crown is the private corporate city of London, and it has 12 council members who serve as representatives for the 13 of the world's wealthiest banking families. The families include the Rothschild family, the Warburg family, the Oppenheimer family, and the Schiff family. The British Parliament and the British Prime Minister serve as a public front to these 13 ruling families. The city-state of London is the wealthiest square mile on the face of the earth. It houses the Bank of England, the London Stock Exchange, all British banks, branch offices of 385 foreign banks, and 70 US banks. It has its own courts, its own laws, its own flag, its own police force, and pays no taxes.
If you want to nail anything down, that is the culture. War is the culture. Dismissal is the culture. Deflection is the culture.
Y'all decked out in police gear for this?
Yes, sir.
You're not on duty though, are you?
Surviving is what I'm doing, man.
You on duty or not?
No.
You're not? Why are y'all in the uniform and everything?
I'm gonna be honest with you, man. I'm not gonna continue this conversation with you.
Again, right. That's you. What happens when you back cops into a corner and they're getting ready to get caught doing something illegal.
We need to speak with the detective about some illegal stuff that we know about.
There's no detectives here.
We got to talk to somebody. We got to make a report on a whole group of police officers that are violating law.
Well, we don't do that here.
You do that here. Sir, what's your name and badge number? No, don't close that window. What's your name and badge number?
Don't open that window.
You open that window, boy.
Is my name Chrissy? Is that what you said?
How would you know about anything in my personal life if you didn't run an illegal investigation?
You
know,
no, you need to do your job.
What do you want?
We need to make a report.
You want your report?
Other police officers breaking the law.
Who?
Clarksville. Get the notepad out.
Nope. Goodbye.
Genocide is the culture. Poverty is the culture.
I like the idea they keep in jail longer. I'm the guy that wrote the bill requiring federal judges to keep people in jail 100% of the time for which they're sentenced. It doesn't matter whether or not they're the victims of society. The end result is they're about to knock my mother on the head with a lead pipe, shoot my sister, beat up my wife, take on my sons. So I don't want to ask, what made them do this? They must be taken off the street. Increase the penalties. Increase them.
I would put the son of a gun in jail.
Put them to death.
Obedience is the culture. Mind control is the culture.
In 1964, Malcolm X published an article in the Egyptian Gazette called Zionist Logic, in which he drew parallels between the oppression of Palestinians and Africans. Instead of seeing it as a religious conflict, Malcolm saw Israel as a colonial project serving a wider imperialist agenda. saying European imperialists wisely placed Israel where she could geographically divide the Arab world. In the same year, Malcolm was one of the first African leaders to publicly meet with the Palestine Liberation Organization, as anti-colonial struggles gained traction through the world. Freedom for Palestinians became a touchstone for the international fight against imperialism. As black freedom movements expanded their worldview to situate their struggle as part of a global anti-colonial movement, Palestine also became an important focal point of their solidarity. On August 15, 1967, the Student Nonviolent Coordinating Committee released a position paper entitled The Middle East Crisis, expressing support for Palestine and criticizing US support for Israel. Organizations such as the Black Panthers argued that freedom would never come for black people in America unless all oppressed people were free. The Panthers frequently spoke of black communities and their relationship with police as living under occupation as internally colonized people. They were vocal in their support for Palestine and met with the PLO in Algiers in 1969.
The destroying of nature is the culture. The destroying of culture is the culture.
Dr. Hacker, it doesn't appear as though you really paint a very pretty picture of white people in general insofar as you see white-black race relations. Can you expound on it, sir?
Well, interestingly, you use the phrase race relations. I don't think there are many relations between black and white people. What I would say very simply is that those of us who are born with this pigmentation have certain privileges, things we can take for granted. You know, we have the safety, the security, so we don't want to lose this. Now, this also means that, and here's the unpleasant part, that so much of our safety, security status comes from putting down black people, saying we're not like them. We're Europeans. We're more highly evolved. You know, we've got talents they don't have. And that's where you get, you know, the flip side of this, which really is the ugly side of racism.
Mm-hmm. Well, how much does sex and sexuality really have to do with race relations, particularly between white men and black men?
Well, if you take white men and black men, let's take it two ways.
Okay.
If a white man is walking down the street and he sees a couple, a very attractive black man, really masculine, and with him a very attractive white woman, you know, very white, we'll make her blonde, you know. He looks at that woman and he wonders, this is the white man, what does she see in him? What do they do together? And it really drives him, us, up the wall, because she's a woman who could choose, you know, a white guy, but she chooses a black guy. And that really bothers us. And as a result, what we want to do is some way take that black man away, you know, because we begin to say, hey, is she having a better time with him, you know, in various ways than she can with me? And so he's competition for us. And you know how people react to competition.
Misinformation is the culture. Masochism is the culture. Beyond being held up by illusion, war, destruction, destroying of the mind, destroying of the body, destroying of the soul.
Ellen Mulvaney just won Woman of the Year. 4 billion women in this world. We're not good enough, apparently. It's insulting.
Giving those opportunities for women to men, it's just sending a message to every woman. And the message that it's sending is that we don't matter. What matters to the people selecting the nominees and the winners of this award and the authority figures and the policies and the Biden administration, the people in the White House, what matters to them is protecting the feelings and the identity of a male at all costs. And I don't know how any traditional feminist could see that and not understand how deeply misogynistic and regressive that is. It's the most ironic and contradictory wave of feminism where we think men make the best women. And it's women fighting for this. That's the message that I know both you and myself are trying to communicate, is look at this for what it is.
Yeah. Because if you are truly a feminist and want the most and the best for women, they're doing quite the opposite of that.
Destroying of nature, destroying of your connection to nature, destroying of each other. The ripping away from the masses. All of that which is natural, only to be replaced by something synthetic.
Climate change, am I right? Yeah, I am off next Monday because of Christopher Genocide Day. Yeah, can I get a glass of water for now? No ice? Science. I think I'll have the pro-choice. You said prosciutto? I too want to travel around the world. Round.
replaced by something given to you by the institution of control, the institution of mind manipulation, the institution of complacency. Because just as I said before, it's not about being something. It's about not being like something else.
I got one. Michelle got one. People you know got one.
Ding dongs.
Maintaining an endless war maintains their protagonistic position in the human story. It's maintained only as a means to cover their history and cover their real intentions. And the way you maintain that mentality to maintain these wars, the internal and external wars, is to control the narrative. Control what people are thinking on a micro level and control what people are thinking on a macro level.
What language did Mexico speak before Spanish? The only single indigenous language spoken by more than a million people in Mexico is the Nahuatl language. The other Native American language with a large population of native speakers include Yucatec Maya.
Did you know in 1820, according to the census of Mexico, 70% of Mexicans spoke an indigenous language?
Did you know that the terms Hispanic, Latino, Mestizo, Mexican, or South Korean, a lot of these terms, actually, all these terms were created by European colonizers who came over to our continent and imposed it on the indigenous population so they could forget their roots and culture.
Should Spain be saying sorry, and should it admit historical responsibility for what happened 500 years ago in what is today Mexico?
Miek tlakame kineltoka tlen poliwini inintlatoli. Ahmo melawak. Miek tlakame ok. Tlahtoa mexicano tlahtoli. Tinochtin tikpia inuelitiyot inikmakamo poliwis.
There are no leaders. There is no moral character out there to evolve towards. There is only what they present as the highest order of moral character. They are the virtue signalers of this realm. Their magic is to maintain the identity of moral superiority handed down by God, enforced by the church of Christianity, and the church of the universe city.
Does anyone want to tell me how in 1927 Universal Studios came up with this picture of the world when the first picture of the world wasn't available until the 1960s through NASA? Almost 40 years later, how did Universal Studios know that this is what the world looked like? Especially from space, when we hadn't been to space yet. Does anyone know? Anyone want to guess?
The reason why science is such a big deal, Western science, is because they are telling you that the understanding of science is the understanding of the nature of God.
So how do we justify, as it were, faith that science will give us the truth? Is that the...
Please.
How do you
justify scientific method?
Yes.
What he said.
It works. It works. Planes fly, cars drive, computers compute.
It's an inductive argument.
If you base medicine on science, you cure people. If you base the design of planes on science, they fly. If you base the design of rockets on science, they reach the moon. It works. Bitches.
And if you understand the nature of God, then you're not only the mind of God, but you're the hand of God.
Bitches.
So science gives you the math of God, and your interpretation of that science is what passes down that authority to you. The university system, understanding this realm with their theoretical interpretations of nature and reality, imposes this belief in the masses of people that they are not only doing the work of God, but in many ways, they are higher than the acts of God. Because the way they have presented God to the masses is very rudimentary. God is this old, decrepit, angry, jealous, irrational thing that contributes to death and destruction around the world. That God is chaotic. We are not chaotic. We are of science.
Bitches.
If you want to find the essence of what this culture is based upon, look at what they're teaching your children. of what they're really trying to push now. Before, they wanted to gain your trust, your belief that they are of a kind heart. They are good-natured. They just want to teach your children so that they become a positive contributor to society. Once they gain that trust, first starting with the church, then going through your education system, now going through the mainstream media and all the other stuff that people believe in, the movies, the music, dumbing down people so low now, they can start installing the programs that move the agenda, move the entire base in the direction which benefits them.
Whose son is this?
Whose son is that?
White idolatry is the worship of white images, okay? White angels and the white Jesus and the angelical realm is white. We have not seen our own divinity. And that's the reason why we as a people have a problem. That's the why you can have that kind of insanity in a nigrotosis mind.
We're one of the few people who don't have a divinity that look like us.
That's not Jesus!
That is called spiritual enslavement. Spiritual enslavement is a complete insanity. This is the epitome of insanity. You can't get more insane than that. Well, that's what I mean by spiritual enslavement.
See, right.
When you take away your own divinity, when you can't look in that mirror and see yourself as a divine spiritual connection to the God itself, to that divine force of the universe that our ancestors called the Creator by many names, this is where you have spiritual enslavement. Where you can have the epitome of the type of ignorance.
First, you got to set the foundation. The foundation was trust. Trust the science, trust the people, trust the culture. Once that's there, now, boom, get the kids. Because the earlier you get the kids, the deeper those mind controls go, the longer they last, and the more effectively they get spread around the masses like a virus. So they hit your value system. To virtue signal to the world that they are the ones who want to protect your children. Creating a problem that wasn't there to begin with. Your kids have an identity problem. We need to make sure that they're protected because the parents are not doing it. The parents aren't responsible for their children anymore. We are. The people don't have their own culture. They don't have their own beliefs. They don't have their own values. We are the ones who give the people their values. So let's base their whole identity around sex. How about that? Why? Because we need people to be emotionally vested into our belief system, into our culture, into our ways of interacting with each other. We need them to believe that we are the hand of God. The parents have already given that authority to us. By allowing this system to educate their children for the majority of their lives. Now that we have that trust, let's move forward. Get them where it's going to last the longest. Hit them in their emotions. Hit them in their reproductive organs. Make it real. Create problems. Manipulate their genetic makeup through the food, through the water. Recalibrate their brain chemistry by fluoridating their water. Adjust their hormones. To be far left or far right, never in the center, never in a balance. Prescribe them poison, drugs that will induce dependency. Get this into generations so that you have chaotic parents raising chaotic children. Imbalanced parents raising imbalanced children. So that we may provide that balance. We may provide that order. We will provide those solutions to raise the consciousness, to raise these masses of people out of their darkness, the darkness that we have created by putting a veil over the sun, by putting a veil over the light of their ancestry. Separate them so far from themselves and where they came from, they will be afraid of their own shadows. They will be afraid of their own reflection. They will not be able to look at themselves in the mirror. They will not only want to bleach their skin, they will want to bleach their genetic makeup. We want to cut them so deep and keep that wound open for so long that the only way that they can walk through life is by maintaining the bandages on those wounds. Consume their lives so much with healing the wounds that we've inflicted on them that they will forget that we were the ones who wounded them in the first place, because we provide them the band-aids. We will put band-aids on the biggest pedestal the world has ever known. They will be so deeply ingrained in our belief systems, in the trust that they have for us, that they will convince other people and their own children, the future generations, they will convince them that this is the way things are supposed to be. Not only is this the only way it's supposed to be, but there is no other way. We have evolved to this point, the highest peak of civilization. There is no other way to be. They've traveled the oceans. They've traveled the skies. They've gone to the moon. They've sent ships to Mars. They've looked into the deepest, darkest depths of the universe. Anything that you can attempt to comprehend in this reality has already been done by them. And they did all of that for us. They provide us our band-aids. How dare you? How dare you try to make me believe that these people do not have our best interests in mind? How dare you? You know what? Something is wrong with you. Do you know what these people are doing? They are trying to protect our world. They care so much about the world. They are investing billions and billions of dollars into protecting us from climate change. They want to protect the oceans. They want to protect endangered species. They want to deflect asteroids from outer space so we don't get destroyed the same way the dinosaurs did. How dare you, sir? Can you stop an asteroid? No, you can't. Can you fix climate change? No, you can't. Can you build our roads? I didn't think so.
Idiots who think that they can do their own research.
Don't do any of your own research.
Doing your own research is associated with
conspiracy theory circles.
This go-it-alone approach, doing your own research,
that can have serious consequences.
You should get prison time for even questioning the vaccines.
Can we all stop saying, I need to do my own research?
That phrase, do your own research, four words, four little words that are hurting America.
Doing your own research hurts America.
Everybody has a supercomputer in their hand that empowers them to do their own research,
and that's the problem. You must not do your own research.
I need to do my own research.
I don't ever understand what that means. I'm doing my own research.
You can't do your own research unless you're a scientist. Don't do your own research.
Maybe you've told yourself you're playing it safe. You just want to wait and see since this is a new vaccine. No.
Grow the up and get the vaccine.
Unvaccinated people spread the virus.
Emotional tethering. Emotional anchoring. If they make you, as a child, dependent on the identity, the relationship with another being.
The most critical time to be there is grades 5 through 8, because you want to catch kids when they're starting puberty, because that's the time in which identity formation is central to their lives. However, early intervention is key. So we actually are designing a kindergarten through grade 2 curriculum this summer.
It's not to have the masses invested in another being. It's to have the masses invested in the system itself. They want you to be so consumed with sex, to be so consumed with relationships, not because they want you to find true love. It's because they want you to be so consumed with that mentality that you won't realize that you become codependent in a relationship. Fucked by the system, spiritually, psychologically, socially, physically, codependent, and in a relationship with the system. Your true love will always be your survival. Your true love is us. Your true love is the system that we have provided for you.
You want to catch kids when they're starting puberty? Because that's the time in which identity formation is central to their lives.
If identity creation is happening at that age, Is identity creation based upon sex in cultures around the world? Why is not identity creation based upon your culture, your ancestry, your character? Why is sex not something that happens naturally as a side dish to the evolving of your character? Why have they made it the centerpiece?
You want to catch kids.
Sex is at the centerpiece of identity because they're looking for a universal manipulation tool to create this human identity. Sex is the centerpiece of your identity creation in the Western public school system because it's the baseline to watering down all cultures, to washing over and washing out all of the belief systems that don't follow along with Western beliefs in order to install this one world, new world, humanistic approach to forward progress, to coming together. Like I said, these are the masters of virtue signaling. They're getting into the roots, into the cores. They're formatting the hard drives of your future generations by washing out everything else that your ancestors passed down to you and replacing it with a synthetic version of human interpretations of this reality.
I love your energy. I love Deepak Chopra. Oh my God, I love quantum physics. That's not what Saint Germain told me. Are you Gemini?
Is there any soy in this?
Wait. Let's pull a card.
Synthetic unification. What's one thing that everybody around the world does? They reproduce. They have sex. They have relationships. They are attempting to tap into the human scope of reality so they can maintain dominance and control over the masses of people who have no identity. They have no ancestral identity. They have no cultural identity. They have no human identity. That's their end. Since they have no culture, since they have been going against the ancestral interpretations of reality, beliefs, morals, values, they have to generate a higher, more evolved interpretation, a more unifying, a more sustainable way of being.
This is what they mean by a sustainable future. These are your 15-minute city smart grid apartments designed to be tiny little cages for not-so-free-range humans. China is the blueprint of the smart grid system, so you only have to look at what's happening there to know what's going to be heading here. Every single movement of every citizen is recorded 100% of the time to monitor their social credit score.
No more this individual, this culture over here and that culture over there. We are the culture of humanity. As they demonize religions, the intentions behind that is to demonize the information, the intelligence, the history of your ancestors. It's not about the world. It's about the individual. It's you. And you, since you have no connection with your ancestors, and since you are unhealthy, you are broken, you are disconnected, you're uprooted, you're unevolved, you're savage. Since you cannot be trusted with the raising of your children, your future generations, we will take over from here.
Early intervention is key.
We represent humanity. What do you represent? We care about you. We care about the world. We care about nature. We care about animals. We care so much about animals, we sleep with them. They're in our homes. They're in our beds. We take them to work. They're a part of the family. Your savage ancestors, all they did was kill animals and eat animals. How primitive and savage is that? We represent veganism. We represent LGBTQ+T, ABCD. The whole spectrum of visible light is who we are. We're everybody. If you're not one of us, then you're one of them. And how dare you, sir? How dare you?
This is the Gamerhood, and you are not welcome.
That's why I need to be here.